Troubling new numbers paint Wisconsinites as often being overweight, but the figures are even less flattering for some. The Night Team's David Douglas has a look tonight. David.
Yeah, Eric, 44% of African Americans in Wisconsin are obese, according to a new report by the Robert Wood Johnson Foundation. And the numbers are puzzling as well, as all other states rating highly for African American obesity are in the South.
Get it, get it, get it, get it.
On a sunny afternoon, these kids on Madison's west side are having a good time.
Get the ball, girl.
Learning that it's good for them.
We want them to be sort of part of their community, but also be taking care of themselves and having fun in a healthy way.
Ready, hey. Madison's Common Council just approved $40,000 for the Meadowood Community Center, allowing them to, among other things, add an outdoor summer program. Funding that comes at a critical time and could be a small part of helping Wisconsin tip the scales.
I think that certainly it's important for people to make healthy choices, but I think what's incumbent upon us is to create environments that allow people to make healthy choices.
Dr. David Allen, head of pediatric endocrinology at UW Health, says what's especially troubling is that while 26% of white Wisconsinites are considered obese, 44% of African Americans are.
So when you look at the statewide comparisons, that's really the biggest discrepancy of any state.
Allen believes the solution won't start in the doctor's office, but by making healthy decisions in the beginning. Like playing outside, eating healthy snacks, and getting your family to do the same.
At the center, we have video games, and I think we just do a pretty good job of kind of portioning out our time to downtime and active time and showing them that you can do both.
Experts do point to economic disparity as part of the problem, not that it makes any sense, but healthy foods are often far more expensive than any of the bad ones.
And looking at these numbers, any response from the state?
Well, they do have a response, and they say, first of all, anytime there is any kind of disparity, they're going to take that very seriously. And a rep for the state health department tells me that addressing disparities in health quality based on race or ethnicity will actually be the foremost public health challenge in the next decade. So it's a pretty strong statement, actually, yes.
All right. News3's David Douglas reporting tonight. David, thank you very much.